Hello and welcome. My name is Carrie and today I'm going to install a PetSafe dog door for this guy here. My dog is 60 pounds and 24 inches at the top of the shoulders, so I bought the large dog door. To begin, I'll remove the hinge pins from the door, then I'll take the door outside and place it on sawhorses. Next, I'll take the template, cut it out for a large dog, and place the top of the template 24 inches from the bottom of the door. There needs to be at least 3 inches of clearance from the bottom and sides of the door to the template to ensure integrity of the door. In my case, there is 4 inches of clearance from the bottom of the door, and I'm centering the template so the sides of the door aren't an issue. With the template in place, I'll tape the edges, then take a straight edge and trace out the lines. The next step is to remove the template, then take a 3/8 drill bit and drill a hole in each corner of the drawn template. Then I'll take a jigsaw and cut out the lines. The dog door comes with 4 plastic core covers. I need to measure the thickness of my door, then add 7/8 of an inch to that measurement. My door is 1¾ inches thick, so if I add 7/8 of an inch to that, my total is 2 5/8 inches. The core covers have spaced grooves, and the 4th groove in is where I want to cut to get the 2 5/8 measurement. When the core covers are cut, I'll push them into the frame with the flap. The core covers have 1 rib opposite the side I cut. This is the edge I want to push into the tabs on the frame. When I get the covers in, I'll duct tape the corners. The next step is to place the interior frame with flap into the cutout, and then from the underside of the door, I'll align the exterior cover. Next, I'll start installing the nylon screws through the holes and into the metal nuts on the bottom. If you have an extra pair of hands to help in this step, it will go a lot faster. As I install the screws, I want to make sure the core covers align with the tabs in the exterior frame. Careful in this step that you don't over-tighten and break the nylon screws. When all the screws are tight, I'll use silicone caulk to fill the gaps. Then I'll rehang the door and cut off the excess length of the screws with wire cutters. The last step is to convince my dog to use the dog door.
Good boy. Good boy.
So that completes this video. And thanks for watching.